For an in-depth explanation of domain, view video of section 7.1, problem 1. Now recall that when we're looking for values that are not part of the domain, what we're really doing is finding values for y that would cause a 0 to appear in the denominator. In other words, which would cause the function to become undefined. We want to stay away from those values. So what we need to do is focus on the denominator and set it equal to 0 and solve for the variable y. We learned in section 6.7 that to solve a quadratic equation, we need to first set it equal to 0 and then factor. This is called the zero factor property. After using product and sum, or trial and error, whichever method you want to use, you'll find that the factorization is y minus 6 times y plus 2. Then we write our two equations, y minus 6 equals 0, or y plus 2 equals 0. To solve the first equation, we'll add 6 to both sides, and we get y equals 6. So this means that y cannot equal 6. It's not part of the domain. Because if we plug 6 into the denominator here in place of y, we'll end up with 0 in the denominator, and we don't want that. To solve the second equation, we'll subtract 2 from both sides, and we get y equals negative 2. So y cannot equal negative 2, because if we plug negative 2 into the denominator in place of y, we will end up with a 0 in the denominator, and we don't want that. So the numbers that should be excluded from the domain are 6 and negative 2. Now the order in which you write these numbers does not matter because it's not an ordered pair and it's not interval notation. Now we're told to write the domain of the function in set notation. What you do, you start off with the variable y, and then you click on cannot equal 6, comma, negative 2. Now even though you have a y written here first, okay, you still have to type the variable again, stating that y cannot equal, you know, whichever numbers that are excluded from the domain. So always look out for that. We'll check our answer. And there we go.